My name is Saif Qureishi and I'm the CEO and Managing Director of KRYFS Power Components Ltd, India. It's been a very interesting journey from the time I graduated from IIM Bangalore in 1988 and I got a job in Grindlay's Bank. And Grindlay's Bank picked up two people from my institute in that year and I was one of them. And unfortunately, my father's business, who had been in business since 1964, was floundering. So I decided to start making transformer laminations or core of the transformer, which is a integral part of the transformer. It was a kind of a forward integration from the raw material that I was importing. Thereafter, for a couple of years, I started in 1992, I started my own factory in Palghar, which is in Maharashtra. And I remember a story where I went to MSFC, Maharashtra State Financial Corporation, for a loan because I didn't have any money to start the factory. A committee of 10 people sitting, and I was sitting in between, and they asked me a question, you know, what collateral can you offer? And I said, I don't have any collateral to offer. And they asked me, why should we invest in you? And at that point in time, mind you, there was no private equity or angel investing. In fact, raising funds was only through the state financial corporations or banks. I'm talking of 1991-92. And, you know, I answered to them that, to this committee of MSFC, that if you don't give young entrepreneurs a chance, the country will never progress. We have four to five different verticals. One, the most important vertical is CRGO transformer laminations, which we supply to large transformer manufacturers like Siemens, Bharat Bijli, Alstom, and about 35 countries all over the world. That constitutes about 70% of our revenues. Then we make transformers up to 10 MVA, 33 kV class, which are supplied to various electricity boards, including UP, Maharashtra, Rajasthan, and various other states in India. Thereafter, we have recently we have entered projects where we are doing one project, the first project in Orissa. We are electrifying about 10 to 15 villages, which will impact the life of 120,000 people. We'll be bringing electricity to their homes. We also have a vertical of material handling business where we manufacture slings which are used for lifting heavy loads in collaboration with Slingmax Inc. of USA. And we have a small consumer division which we basically sell household cutlery and knife products. This particular division was started long back and it's a traditional division, and we are available at most of the big bazaar retail stores. Quality is something which you cannot necessarily ensure, but it has to become a part of your DNA of the organization. Because when you try to ensure quality, you can fail. But when quality becomes a part of your DNA of the organization, then it's a presumed constant which every customer of yours can expect. If I'm buying from KRYFS, I'm going to get a quality product. For KRYFS, the major achievement is that over the last 23 years of our existence, profitability has not been the sole objective over here, but building an excellent organization. Like they say in the movie Three Idiots, Kabil Bano, Kamyabi Tumhare Piche Aayegi. That I truly believe in. And I think there have been times when we have sacrificed profitability for various other factors like creating value for stakeholders, which are employees, our customers, our suppliers. And I think the major achievement that KRYFS today has is that we are a value-based organization. The biggest innovations which we at KRYFS were responsible for, and for which we also got the ASSOCHAM Innovations Award last year out of tens of thousands of companies who applied for that award, was we were successfully able to reduce the no-load losses of transformers by 6 to 8% by introducing the step-lap technology to India. Now this is a little bit technical, I understand, but look at it as making the transformer, which is the heart of the power system, more efficient by 6 to 8% without the cost of a single rupee either to the customer or to anyone else. And I think this has been our major innovation.
As an entrepreneur, there are three things which you must take care of if you wish to be successful. Number one is time management, managing your own time, doing the high priority things first and not doing things which are not important, and a lot of those come up as an entrepreneur. Second important thing in my thinking is cash management. A lot of companies, startup companies, small companies fail because they are not able to manage cash flow effectively. And cash flow is at the heart of any business. Like an old saying goes that turnover is vanity, profits is sanity, but cash flow is reality. And the third most important thing is people management and relationship management. And when I say people and relationship management, I mean not just external, that is with customers and your suppliers, but even internal, with your managers, with your employees, with people who work for you. The vision of KRYFS is to set the benchmark for quality, service and reliability for the products marketed and manufactured by us, resulting in growth and value for all stakeholders. Processes and systems at KRYFS are an integral part of our manufacturing system. Not only we have ISO 9000, ISO 14000, ISO 18000, but we are also working closely with our investors, Toyota Tsusho, to implement the Toyota production system, which is one of the number one production systems in the world. Besides that, technology plays a very important role in everything which we do. My advice to upcoming young entrepreneurs would be that when you're leaving the security of a paycheck, or if you've never worked before and you've never seen the security of a paycheck, please ensure that you're comfortable with taking risk, because being an entrepreneur means taking risk. And if you're not comfortable with risk taking, you will burn your heart and your money, and you will possibly not end up being successful. The second thing I would like to say is get some idea about financial management, because if you don't have any idea about finances, you would not be able to raise funds, you may not be able to discuss with angel investors, private equity investors, and also you would not be able to have a sense of how your business is doing. So if you don't have any education on finance, get some idea about what a balance sheet means, how to read a balance sheet. Third thing is, if you have an idea or if you have a business project which you think that you wish to implement, try and run different scenarios on it. What is the best case scenario? What is the worst case scenario? And always hope for the best, but prepare for the worst.